Okay, so we're going to add some wiring here. We're going to put some lights up in a shop, and we're going to use some 14-2 American wire gauge. That's 14 is American wire gauge. Here in the country I was born in, we use a 14 gauge wire on 15 amps, 12 gauge wire on 20 amps, and 10 gauge wire on 30 amps. Black is live, white is neutral. Bare green is the ground, and blue and red are also live colors, but there are some instances where the white wire could be live, and that's on a 220-240 volt circuits where the appliance does not require a neutral, and also switch loops. So we're going to go and add some lights in a shop. And there you can see the wires made here in the country I was born in. Okay, so we're going to take down this knob and tube wiring here. And we're going to have some holes. So we don't have to drill new holes to run our next new wire. And surprisingly, this knob and tube isn't all that brittle. I bent it and it didn't even crumble. you can't open one, you just go to another one. Don't worry about what you cannot do. You just can't. Staple twist, you know what? The staple is the boss, you're not the boss. So you just leave it and don't mess with it. Twisted together here. Clip them so they're even. Oh, how lovely. I don't have my wire nuts. Another ground wires together here. And we'll pull them up into the box, get them up all the way here. With our 14 gauge hole. And we always loop the wire the direction that the screw turns, because if you turn it the wrong, put it around the screw the direction that, the opposite direction when you tighten the screw will open the loop. What I like about the Eaton brand is you can put two wires on this rather than just one. So I'm going to open our screws up here. Okay, we'll put our two black wires on the brass screw here. Make sure we're not getting any insulation under the screw head there. Put another black wire on this one. Here in the country I was born in, the black is live and the white is neutral. Black goes on the brass colored screw and the white goes on the silver colored screw. Just double checking, make sure I didn't get the insulation caught under the screw head. And I didn't. And I like these boxes because they come with screws in them. Okay, so we'll push our wires up into the box, make sure our wires don't get pinched in between anything. We don't want them to cross over the terminals, and we don't want them to get pinched. So we'll just look and make sure everything's going where I want them to. Locked in nice and snug there. We'll just tighten it so we don't break our fixture, just that snug. Now look, make sure no wires are pinched, and now we're ready to go on and add our next fixture. going to salvage some of the older wiring here. And as you see, it has paper wrapped around the black and white conductor. This is only for lights, so we're going to use it because it's in excellent shape. It doesn't have a ground wire, so we cannot put any outlets on this. It's just for porcelain light fixtures without any outlets on it, so we'll be okay without a ground wire. The wire is in good shape. There's nothing wrong with it. It's probably, I'm going to guess, 50 years old. But it's not brittle, it's not in bad shape. Okay, so we're going to fold this ground wire up nice and small, and we're going to get it up out of the way. And we're going to make sure it doesn't touch any terminals on our light fixture, and it's out of the way of everything. So we're going to get all the way up here in the back of the box, all the way up at the top. Let it lay. Just let it lay. I'll get it when I need it. Okay, I'm going to put our light fixture up. I'll open up our two brass screws here for our black wires. And I'll open up our two white wires for the silver screw. Make my loops the direction that the screw turns. You always put your wire around the screw the direction that the screw turns, so that when you tighten your screw, it closes the loop rather than opens the loop. And a little long too, not much. Okay, so we'll put our two black wires on the brass screw. On the silver colored terminals here. Are we using tight. Okay, so you can see it hooked up there. Okay, now we can fold our wires up into the box. We're gonna make sure our wires don't cross over the terminals here. And they don't get pinched anywhere. I'll just make sure no wires are pinched. Okay, I'll talk to you about stripping this older wire. I'll show you how to do it. This is a cloth on the outside. It is rubber and cloth on the inside, but it's in really nice shape. So we will peel it down the middle here. Might have to do it a couple times because the insulation on the outside is kind of tough. There we go. And we'll take back the older tar, and there's paper underneath here. See the paper? And there's a string in here to pull it back. Then you take your side cutters and you just cut it off like you do with the newer wire. And then the conductors have this paper wrapped around them. You just unwrap it like this. You do the same with the black wire. So not all knob and tube is very old and brittle. See how I'm bending that? This is that piece I took down earlier in this video. And it's not even crumbling or breaking anywhere. We're screwing into some hardwood, so it is what it is. I'm not going to frustrate. It's in. Okay, so we'll make our loops the direction that the screw turns here. Black goes on the brass, white goes on the silver. Fixture up into the box, make sure our wires don't cross over the terminals and nothing's pinched. Screwed up just snug so we don't break the fixture, and we will put a couple more staples down here off camera. Alrighty, so that is how to wire porcelain light fixtures to put on a ceiling in a barn or in a garage or in the attic or cellar of a house here in the country I was born in. Peace. Thanks for watching.